Hello, Vidya. I'm very happy to see you today. Dr. Vidya Yerevdeka from Symbiosis International University. Thanks for taking the time. I know this year is the Golden Jubilee of Symbiosis. So I wonder if you could maybe start by telling us something about why it's an international university.
Okay, so Symbiosis as an organization started way back in 1971. And it was established by a teacher of botany, Dr. S.B. Muzumdar, and I'm proud to say I'm his daughter. And he established this organization for the welfare of foreign students who came to study in the city of Pune in India, in the state of Maharashtra. So even in the 70s, there were a lot of foreign students who came and studied here. But they faced a lot of problems of language, which was English. They came from non-English speaking backgrounds. Food, accommodation, homesickness, and several other social problems. So he, as a professor and who was looking after, the hostels where foreign students lived, he was also the foreign students advisor by the university, appointed by the university. So when he realized the problems, he felt that he should establish a small organization that actually was born in a house. Mm-hmm. And any foreign student who would feel homesick and would want to be eating good food, good Indian food, just come and stay with us or just come and have lunch with us. So I've lived my childhood, with a student from Iran, a student from Africa, someone from Bhutan or Thailand. So, it was such a wonderful experience that these foreign students came and stayed with us while they studied in different colleges in Pune city. But then I think Dr. Muzumdar realized that, just doing these simple things is not enough. He needs to actually provide good education so that, Indian and foreign students can actually learn together. Mm-hmm. And, there will be more international understanding that could be promoted. And he realized that the biggest problem of foreign students at that point in time was English communication. Mm-hmm. Because majority of them came from West Asia and Southeast Asia and typically Afro-Asian countries. And therefore, he started teaching them English. In our own house. So a room was converted into a classroom and he would teach English free of cost, of course. And, there were a lot of students from Iran and my mother actually learned Persian so that they could actually feel comfortable. And that's how the whole story began. So it began with a setting up of an English language teaching institute of Symbiosis, while my father still kept teaching botany in one of the state affiliated colleges, which is affiliated to the state university, Ferguson College. And he decided a name to this not-for-profit organization, a small organization that he started, and he felt Symbiosis was the apt name because it meant living together of two different organisms for mutual benefit. Mm-hmm. So he believed that Indian and foreign students would actually live together for mutual benefit. Uh-huh. So with that noble cause, the journey began. And over the last 50 years, it has transformed into one of the largest universities in India, with campuses across six cities in India, and a largest cohort of international students, more than 3,000 international students from 85 different countries.
Yeah.
And we all know that internationalization at that point in time and even now meant foreign students. Mm. So, if you say that so-and-so university is an international university, it means that it has a large number of foreign students. Mm-hmm. But honestly, for Symbiosis, it didn't mean that. It meant that it meant something much larger. It meant, how do you bring in this whole element of cultural sensitization? How do you bring in this whole element of diversity and diverse discussions in classrooms? This whole element of thinking about each other, feeling about each other, and bringing in this whole concept, which is called in Indian mythology, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. The world is one family. So how do you make these young students believe that the whole world is one family and we need to care for each other in the larger context of peace, bringing in peace? Yeah. So this was the concept. And I think over the last 50 years, this university has been transformed into just a small organization, which was established for foreign students, to a large university, which actually promotes internationalization of higher education.
And we were talking about, we've been talking about internationalization at home and internationalization of the curriculum. And you've seen that transformed presumably over the time as well, have you?
Of course, yes. I mean, I think the aspirations of even Indian students who join any university are such that they need these global competencies to be instilled. So, you know, in 1991, actually, the Indian government kind of liberalized everything. So we talk about this whole liberalization, privatization and globalization movement in India. And I think as an impact of this globalization, it was imperative for universities in India also to bring in this element of internationalization in their curricula, in their higher education. Mm-hmm. And so did Symbiosis too. I mean, Symbiosis has done a lot of, a lot in the area of internationalization at home, mm-hmm. not just about bringing in this element on campuses where, you know, we have international students' homes and residences, international cuisine being served in cafeterias, international festivals being celebrated, the national days of several countries being celebrated, a dedicated day on the 31st of July being celebrated as the International Students Day, to actually bringing in internationalization in the curriculum, mm-hmm. so that, when students get placed, they don't get placed only in Indian companies, but even in multinational companies that come to, give employment to our students. Mm-hmm. So, this has been the transformation from international students to internationalization at home.
Yeah. So do you think in that time, have you seen changes within the Indian government approach to internationalization as well? Have you seen other universities following similar ways forward that Symbiosis has?
Yes, even when Symbiosis, I had been doing this in since the last almost a decade, we've been seeing that many other Indian universities, have been promoting internationalization, not just attracting foreign students to their campuses, but even, practicing internationalization at home. But there were just a handful of them, maybe just about 4 to 5 in a large pool of almost 1,000 universities now in India. But since the last 3 years, what I have noticed personally is that we're seeing a change in the policymaking several bodies in the government of India. In fact, just before this conversation, I was in a meeting where, we were talking to the Ministry of Commerce, so look at this. I mean, it wasn't just the Ministry of Education thinking about internationalization, but even the Ministry of Commerce, because they believe that education is a great service that can be exported under the, exportable services. Mm. So we've been seeing this, seeing a change. In fact, about 10 years ago, when I was in some of these government bodies as a member of the University Grants Commission and several other government bodies, not just me, but some of my colleagues would kind of really push this whole agenda, but nobody looked at it. But now, I think since the last 3 years, and our Prime Minister has also been very proactive, and he's been personally looking at why aren't foreign students coming to India? What can you do to promote internationalization? I think it's like, percolating it from the top.
Okay.
And therefore, we change. In a new education policy that has been framed recently, of course, it is yet to be rolled out. It's almost ready. We see a whole chapter on internationalization of higher education, which is something which we felt really very happy about.
Yeah. And I'm guessing partnerships have been quite a major factor. I know my former university is partnered with Symbiosis as well. So I think I'm guessing it's not simply a question of coming from within that the Indian government sees this, but they want to collaborate with other universities in different parts of the world as well.
Right, absolutely. And it's like universities have also been very proactively wanting to partner with foreign universities, not just to not just for an exchange program, but really to learn some best practices of what's happening all across the globe. There's been a lot of mobility, even an outward mobility of Indian students going on semester abroad programs, Indian faculty going in, teaching in some foreign universities, and also having reciprocal faculty coming in, teaching at Indian universities. So I think the government is also encouraging these kind of partnerships and collaborations. Actually, a few years ago, they had tabled the Foreign Education Provider Bill, in our Indian Parliament, but that didn't see the light of the day because it was toppled down, but it meant that foreign universities could actually come and land in India and could set up campuses. Mm. But then the government realized that I think the better way would be collaborations with some of the best universities across the world, mm. To upgrade some of our own Indian universities and also look at a very active collaboration by way of not just we learning from them, but even they learning from us. Mm. So the government has been supporting a lot of collaborations. The government itself has rolled out some programs, like there's a program called Gyan, which is a global initiative of academic network, which is a funded program where foreign faculty is paid by the government to come and teach. You know, here there is a program that has been rolled out called Study in India program, where scholarships are provided to foreign students to come and study in some of the top Indian universities. There has been a ranking of Indian universities now that has been announced since the last almost 4 to 5 years. And that gives a good opportunity to even select some of the top Indian universities for such activities by the government. So, you know, they're very focused activities of internationalization that the government is now really looking at.
Of course, not everybody agrees with rankings, but I guess it's inevitable one way or another. But it's interesting to see how things are developing. And I know you've said that you're also trying to set up a network for international education as part of, under the Association of Indian Universities. Do you think that will help? Will that benefit Indian universities in some respect?
Yeah, I think so, because, you know, as I said, that there are a handful of Indian universities that are way ahead in internationalization, but the others also aspire to be. So we felt that, it's good to have a network called Indian Network for Internationalization of Education, because, in some universities, there's not even an international office, leave alone talking about internationalizing the curriculum and so on and so forth. So what do we do with, universities that really need some kind of mentoring and handholding? So we felt that we should have a network of like-minded universities. It could be membership through university memberships, or even institutional memberships. There could be industries who would want to partner in this network. Some of the foreign, networks, that may want to come and, set up some chapters in India. And I think it's all about collaboration. You know, a network is all about collaboration. It's not just one-sided, but it's both sides and both-sided. And then you learn some best practices. So the whole network is also to build capacity in some of our universities that really need so. And we felt that if there is a strong African network for international education, then India, I think it was high time that we had a network ourselves. And the best part is that we've been talking about this since the last 4 years. We've been giving our representation to the Ministry of Education, the Ministry of Human Resource Development in India, but it wasn't taken up seriously. But now the Association of Indian Universities, which is a kind of a quasi-governmental organization, which has memberships of almost more than 600-700 universities, they have taken it up seriously. It's just been approved by their governing board, and we will see an active network with an official secretariat and all the necessary administrative powers responsible for this to function happen very soon. So I'm very happy, because I've been promoting this for a long time, and I always feel that I go for and see so many such activities happening all across the world, and we need such a thing in India.
So you've obviously had a very long history with international collaboration, even at the individual student level. Do you think that internationalization in India is following a kind of a specific Indian route, or do you feel that people are copying what's happening in other parts of the world?
Honestly speaking, some of them are trying to copy, and I always feel that you should see every university has its own DNA. So I think you need to maintain that identity, and with a country like ours, which has such a strong history, such a strong culture, and I think we need to bring in those elements of Indianness when it comes to internationalization. So even if you look at the students who come, for example, we have some students who come from Europe, from UK, from US on a semester exchange or short-term study abroad programs. Now they're so excited, not really to learn Indian economy, but honestly speaking, to learn Indian culture, Indian history, yoga, and those typical Indian traits that they really have just heard about, but not really experience. So I think it's all about giving an experience. So even in this whole process of internationalization, I always feel that countries need to maintain their identity and give an experience to a student of that culture, then really just look at, you know, the academic part of internationalization. So whenever our students also go abroad, we have a very strong global immersion program where we encourage our Indian students to go abroad. We even fund some of them. And we always tell them that it's not about learning, you know, academics in sitting in a classroom there in that country, but knowing more about that country, you know, you're getting in to know that culture, the food and everything about it, because that's what is going to remain etched in your minds than really just about, you know, just academics. So
yeah.
I think all those, you know, even the non-academic, or you call it the co-curricular part, is far more important at times than just academics.
Well, it's really interesting talking to you today, and thank you very much for explaining all that, and good luck with the setting up of the network. It sounds as though that could be really interesting, and it's fascinating to hear how things have developed so far. Thanks very much for speaking to me today, Vidya.
Thank you, Elspeth. Thank you very much. Yeah.